JC Conf 2018精彩议程，由 Soft Leader 松林科技保险核心系统领导厂商 ，OS 号召各路顶尖人才携手放眼亚太 ，Line 拉近你我的距离，赞助为您播出。
Hello everyone, I'm Naoki Takezue from Japan. I'm a Scala programmer. Work.Treasure data. Today I'd like to talk about my personal open source project, Gitbucket, which is an open source self-hosting Git server on JVM. And so, in fact, Gitbucket is written in Scala, but today I want to talk about harmony of Scala and Java, right? So let's get started.Gitbucket is this, so which is a software to install GitHub-like software development platform to your server. And so it's similar to GitLab or you may know GitHub, Gox, etc. And so important thing is it's built onThe top of pure JVM technologies. So, and again, it's not related to my job. It's completely my personal work. And so, to start Gitbucket, Gitbucket is provided as executable file, so you can run by just downloading.File from this URL and hit this command. It's super easy. If you have or you already have Java on your machine, yeah, that's it. And also, official Docker image is available. So, yeah, it's easy to run as well. But online demo site is available on Herok, so you can.Access this URL and try Gitbucket without any installation. So let's access this URL right now. And this is the current status of Gitbucket. We have more than 7,000 stars on GitHub and a lot of users all over the world. Do you know Gitbucket? Hands up.And do you use it? Oh, good. Yeah, I should ask this question first of my presentation. Cool. So next is, what was motivation when we started Gitbucket? And, main target of Gitbucket is in-house Git repository, of course. And so sometimes we can't use external Git hosting services like GitHub or Bitbucket for some reason, like company's security policy or contract with customers. Yeah, I think it's understandable. It's our business.And of course, we have some solutions for that, like GitHub Enterprise or GitLab. But in our case, GitHub Enterprise was expensive, and we didn't have money for buying GitHub Enterprise. And GitLab installation and also upgrading was awkward. Was a little complex. I know GitLab installation has been now improved, but it was a bit complex at that time. So I thought I must make it by myself, and of course in Scala. Cool. So it was our motivation. At the first time. And so let's look at the feature of Gitbucket. This is Repository viewer, we can browse files in the Git repository and also edit files directly on the browser. And issues is similar to GitHub's one. GitHub now supports multiple assignees. Gitbucket does not support multiple assignees. And pull request is also similar to GitHub. And Gitbucket has a lot of features like this. I think it's enough as a software development platform, and in particular for small teams. So, and Gitbucket has plugin system, you can add new features or your own requirement by writing a plugin. And of course, Gitbucket plugin should be written in Scala. There are a lot of existing useful plugins. I introduced some of useful plugins. The first is Kanban and Gantt chart plugin. They are third-party plugins and which visualizes the status of issues and pull requests as views, Kanban and Gantt chart views. I think it would be a help for project management on Gitbucket. And this interesting plugin is CI plugin. This plugin offers continuous integration functionality on Gitbucket. And sometimes configuring Jenkins with GitHub is it's not easy, but this plugin is fully integrated with Gitbucket, so you don't need to any additional configuration. Just install plugin and use it. And so this is the most important plugin, I think, is Excel Viewer plugin. Someone tend to abuse Excel for any purpose. In such situation, this plugin is really helpful. But unfortunately, this plugin is still under development. One committer of Gitbucket is developing this plugin, but it's not still under development. We can't use this plugin immediately. So this is a list of other useful plugins. I think you can find suitable plugin for in your use cases from these plugins. But if you can't find good plugin, so I hope that it's a time to write Scala to make your own Gitbucket plugin for you. Yeah, I hope so. And so next is technology inside of Gitbucket. And this diagram shows technology stack of Gitbucket. Gitbucket is typical web application written in Scala, but it has some special functionality and like Git server functionality, and also it has it allows SSH access to Git repositories. I will talk about them later. First, I'd like to introduce Scala frameworks. Gitbucket uses Scalatora as a web framework and Slick as a database access library. So first is Scalatora. Scalatora is a simple and lightweight web framework for Scala, and it's obviously inspired by Sinatra, Ruby web framework, you may know. So the naming is Scalatora. Naming of Scalatora is very simple. And of course, application code is simple, very simple and understandable. And Slick, I say that Slick is a database access library, but in fact, it's type-safe query builder like this. And yeah, this is a tiny example with yeah, simple inner join, but we can write more complex query like yeah, nested subqueries or huge union queries. Of course, with type safety. I think Slick is a good example of language internal DSL in Scala. Yeah, it's really cool. But the important thing in Gitbucket is core technologies are all Java components, JTH to JGit and Apache Miner, SSHD. This red blocks in the this diagram is a core part of Gitbucket, and they are all Java components. So yeah, Git server functionality is made by JGit. JGit is a pure Java implementation of Git, and SSH server functionality is made by Apache Miner SSHD. Apache Miner is yeah, a framework for async non-blocking server application, and Miner SSHD is yeah, SSH server implementation based on Apache Miner. And yeah, to provide executable WAR file, we use embedded JT, and as a default database, we use H2 database as a in embedded mode. So these all component is written in Java. So I mean, the key is interoperability of Scala and Java. Yeah, you may know Scala has good interoperability with Java. And so Java has a lot of existing libraries or middlewares, in particular in low layers. So we can get benefits from them even in Scala. So yeah, use Scala and Java together is the so I'm sorry, and Scala is good language, I think. It's very productive programming language. But use Scala and Java together is the best way to get productivity in Scala. So yeah, so this is what I wanted to say in this presentation. Yeah, so Scala versus Java, no. This it's so yeah, no, we don't choose either Scala or Java. We can use Scala and Java together. So anyway, try Gitbucket and give your star on GitHub if you like it. And I have some today. I have some Gitbucket sticker like this. So catch me to get a sticker after this talk. That's it. Thank you for listening.